Sir Edwards, how are you today? There you are. Look, come on in. Right, so we're here to discuss somebody. Who is that person? Right, we have a young girl called Becky. She's had quite a hard upbringing. She lived with her father, who is an alcoholic, and now she's in care.
Okay.
So, what about the education history? Do you have anything on that? Anything that she succeeds or anything?
Absolutely not. I think I know what I'm talking about.
Okay. Right, so what are we going to do with it then?
Well, since I have worked with quite a few people in Becky's case, I think the best thing would be to start her off in the low sets, then obviously she can work herself up and prove herself.
Okay, so you are happy with that? You're obviously happy with that, so it's time to get the parents in back in?
Yes.
Yes?
Oh, good morning.
Hello, hello, my name is Mr. Farwm.
I'm Mr. Price, I teach you at school.
Hi.
Right, so if you'd like to come in. And I shall now hand you over to Mr. Edwards.
Yes, I'm Becky's a social worker, and me and Mr. Price have been having a conversation. And we've come up with the decision that the best thing for Becky would be to start off on the lower steps, and then she can work herself up. But I'm sure you agree, because I never get in trouble.
Well, we completely agree with you because obviously we've worked with you for a couple of years now and you obviously know best. And Becky's been with us for a couple of months now and we still don't feel as if we know it.
That's it, the decision's been made, we don't need to question you guys. We don't need to hear what you're
talking about. I think you should listen to Becky.
Right, what can Becky do to get a sort of listening?
Yeah, that is the intention here, isn't it?
We don't know anything about Becky's ability, educational ability, okay? None at all. And these people don't seem to care. What do you think about the foster parents here? What kind of people basically seem to be? Yeah, they're fine, but they're pushovers, really, aren't they? Pushovers. They obviously seem to know what Mr. Edwards thinks is best, basically, don't they? Foster then is trying to sort of...
She's a bit nicer, she comes across a bit nicer than the two. You give Becky a chance to say something, really, but she loses that chance, unfortunately. So if you were Becky, what would you do? Get yourself hurt, yeah? Amazing. Do you want to swap places with Becky? Do you want to fight?
Come on.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
I'm just... Neu sa'ch chi yn edrych, sa'ch chi, Becky. Cael dy hun, cael dy rai, dwoad. Did
you see that?
No?
Can you see? No. Well, ti'n go back? Just i weld, sut fe sa'ch hyn yn ymwneud? Ti'n cael go back am hyn?
We don't like...
So do you agree with Effie? Yeah? So shall you as Effie, you're going to, what's your intention now? To get the voice heard. Okay, fantastic. And what, well, let's see what you've got to say. Shall we go, where do you want to go from?
Just back from now.
Start from when, well, Lynn, do you want to start? We just sat down here, and then shall we start from there? So the family have just taken their seats. Yes?
Yes, I'm Becky's a social worker. Me and Mr. Price have been having a conversation, and we think the best thing for Becky would be to start off in low sets. Obviously, you can prove yourself then, and I'm sure you agree because I never get things wrong.
Well, we totally agree because we've worked with you for a couple of years now and Becky's been with us for a couple of months and we still don't feel as if we know you. So.
Thank you. Well, this is his name, and no more question about it.
Do I have to say something?
Yes, I do.
You don't want to hear what Becky has
now,
to say.
Now, excuse me. Excuse me for a moment, but I do have something to say. I disagree with what you want me to do. Because I want to try the higher set to see how far I can take push myself.
I think I can slightly move,
but you don't know what I'm capable of.
Also, as you're capable of, I've worked with you for many years now, and...
Yeah, but you never listen to me once.
I do listen to you.
No, you do not.
I do listen to you.
No, you don't.
Because I...
What are your demands, Becky?
My demands are that I want to try the highest head first, and if I fail to catch up with the highest head, then put me in the lowest head.
Absolutely not.
And why not?
That is a risk, and a risk I'm not going to take. I know the best for you, I just think.
Maybe I can wait for
Why is that a risk for him? Why is he not
there? I'm scared that I might prove you wrong, but... I'm so scared. Are you worried that your professional career is going to be on the line if I prove you wrong, sir?
Yes, boy.
I don't know why you are suddenly trying to. You've said a bunch of bottles, which you never did, but I don't think in the first place.
Well, things have changed. And I think it's time that I finally put my voice over.
Can we make some decisions? Shall we try and get some decisions made here?
Yes.
What about the headmaster here? He's the headmaster of the secondary school. He's extremely quiet in the situation. Do you want to kind of...
Yes.
How can we get him?
You're quiet, headmaster. Why don't you say something? What do you think is me as a person?
You don't want to get yourself expelled before starting.
First of all, professionally, I agree with Mr. Redlands because he's been in this line of work for, well, longer than you've been alive. So he knows what he's doing. And I'm not thinking he's being unreasonable or unfair here because it is a risk.
But don't you think that every student has a special ability inside themselves? They have their own unique skills, their own unique weaknesses and strengths.
And this is where the performance will be picked up on in lower sets because they'll thrive more.
But
sorry, is that true? What you just said? That sounds like a complete lie to me.
It does sound like a lie. But that's a lie. If I have to prove myself in the lower sets, nobody's going to know it. If I have to prove myself in the higher sets, then people aren't going to know it.
What do you think, Mr. Price?
Shut them up then. You shut them up then. You shut them up then.
We'll see how you are in the bottom sets for the first term. If you do prove yourself, you can't go up sets. However, if you don't, then we obviously make the right decision.
Well, we know what's coming, don't we? We know that Becky, in the future, the next week, she's having fantastic results, and she's had fantastic results in her exams and her coursework for a long time. So we know that she's going to do well. Are we going to sort of, are you happy with what Mr. Price has just said, that you start for the term in sort of bottom set, and then you're going to try and,
If I do prove myself, will I guarantee I'll be in one of the higher sets? If I truly do prove myself.
I'll lay it out on the table for you. If you do prove yourself, you can.
What do you mean by that, sir?
Well, I suppose I've got to do something on this match that won't be natural.
Are you guys happy with that? Is that good enough for now? Okay, yeah. Anybody got anything else to add? Or do you want to add more? Has anybody got anything else to say?
It's nice of Becky out, that's getting reassurance from the parents, for the parents now, the foster parents, to back up what she wants, because she is the most important person in the situation.
Exactly. So you need to make sure that you've got that support network, really, haven't you? That's a support behind you. Are you going to try and get the foster parents sort of
Well, more to you?
I guess.
Got anything to say to them at all? What's the man? Have you got, you seem quite kind-hearted. You gave Becky a chance to speak earlier. Would you be happy to support her a bit more? Would you be a bit more What stops you from being a bit more, a bit louder? Is he something to do with it? Okay, foster dad. Can we get some more support, Becky, from your side, from home?
But we do work in the theatre for a while.
I know you love to work with us. I know. Okay.
But we're asking here. So Becky, have you got anything to say to your foster dad?
I understand that you appreciate Miss Edward's passion.
Yeah.
I can't if you don't help me.
Oh, okay. No. Has anything else got anything to add to this? Would anybody else do things, anything a bit differently? It isn't him, yeah. But unfortunately, you can't just pay. You want to do that, yeah. Would you have a different argument to him? Kieran, would you have different arguments to Kieran? No? You deal with it the same way as Kieran's dealt with it, but you still want to get rid of him. What would stop Becky from getting a different social worker? Shall we move on to the second scene to see what we do with the second scene? So, come on, what about social worker?
Oh, the bag. Fucking really, that felt better.
Yeah.
You didn't
I'm really glad that somebody, nobody let that go. Put it in the sock. Did you say sock? Yeah. Why did you say sock? If you were Becky, now Becky didn't say anything, but I think he's a sock. If you were Becky, what would you do? What would you do if you played that? Why do you think he's got so much of an opinion? Why is he worried? Why is he not doubting her ability to go to university?
Because it looks bad on him if she's...
Maybe, yeah. Anything else?
Because
it doesn't look bad. Yeah.
He's stubborn.
Just wanting to move
on. Yeah, and also if she's, in this situation in care, then who's going to pay for her to go to university? The social worker, but the the system. So maybe that's an aspect. Does anybody want to change? Should Dovany see what
I'll go. Yeah.
Come on. Don't have to act. Just do what you would do naturally.
Gosh.
What is
it? Else do you need? Go.
Come
on,
see. Basic thing is what I know.
Don't worry, I just they thought I got on the university.
Okay. Yeah? Yeah. Heads up. Do you want to talk to
her about
Becky?
Okay.
I'm not sure I need. Okay, Mr. Douglas.
Message number.
Robin Leia. Let's see that go.
I'm not having this university application at all. It's going to be expensive.
Whoa! Stop trying to spoil my
listen! I should see the future, so I'm smoking in university and get a job! Why can't you just do one?
Are we going anywhere with this? Try and resolve this scene now, okay? We'll try and resolve this scene because what we want is for Becky not to. For what happens in the last scene, and we all know what happens in the last scene, okay? We don't want that to happen, basically. And what do you think needs to happen?
Yes, you do have the results here. If you
you must go to university, then you can go. Yeah. Take it and get out of my office.
Now I'm going to take a job.